All right, guys, welcome back. We are here with weekly uploads yet again. Today, we are going back to the Piper Arrow to balance a prop because it's totally screwed. So we're going to head out to the airport and do that. Now, before we get into that really quick, Aircraft Spruce loved the response of the last giveaway video I did. So they sent me 10 more gift cards to give away to you guys. So make sure to subscribe because the only way to win is subscribe. I'm going to be giving Aircraft Spruce gift cards away in tons of upcoming videos. So make sure to subscribe to that. Also, I'm at home right now sitting in my right-hand drive Acura Integra Type R that I just imported from Japan. I've been getting a lot of requests of video from you guys for videos to show off the shop and all the different cars I have. So that's also coming up. So make sure you're subscribed and ready for that. But enough of me yapping. Let's get into this video and go balance this propeller. See you out there. All right, guys, good morning. Short video today. I'm out here with the Arrow, which I did wind up buying. Update video coming on that whole process. I'm out here with my good friend Leo right now. We're doing a propeller balance on the airplane. There's just a little bit of a vibration in there that I don't like. He has done all of my planes for years. Good friend of mine. He uses this awesome machine. I'll show you guys. There is newer, better tech out there in the world, but he's been balancing my props for 10 years now, and it works really well, really smooths out what's going on. So yeah, that's what we're getting into today. Like I said, this is gonna be a pretty quick video. I'm gonna talk you guys through kind of what the process is in doing this stuff. So basically what we did, we just kind of did a baseline run right now. We start the engine, put vibration sensors on it, and we're measuring in inches per second of how much the prop flange or the prop itself is actually vibrating in comparison to the engine. And he can tell everything. He's been doing this for so long that he knew that at 1700 RPM, my vibration was coming from my fuel mixture just being rich, it's cool out. I'm not adjusting the mixture because we're roughly at sea level here at Fullerton. So that being said, right now what he's doing, he's gonna pull the spinner off. As he's pulling the spinner off, he's gonna go ahead and add a couple weights to clean up what we have on there. We're gonna run it again, which I'll show you guys here shortly. We'll run it up to 1700, he'll take the measurements, then I'll run it up to 2000, he'll take the measurements, we'll see where the vibration is, and then he'll adjust the weights. He'll adjust the weights to kind of alleviate that. So that's kind of what's going on today. So what he's doing right now is he's removing the spinner, and if you can see in here, this little doodad right there, that's a weight in there, and he's going to adjust those weights so the prop is properly balanced. So now that you guys are getting a little acquainted with the process, that's it. Here's what the prop looks like with no spinner on, and I'll show you that weight nice and closely now.
Here's the thing I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna replace all this rusty weight. And I see there's a weight over right here.
Yeah.
Instead of adding weight, I'm gonna remove some of the washers.
Okay.
And that's the only thing I'm gonna do.
Okay.
I'm not gonna add anything, but the thing about here, I have to replace it.
That's that vibration sensor there, mounted to the case, and he runs the wire out here along the side of the plane, out of the way of the prop, all the way around and back to the machine. So balancing the prop is really beneficial to basically everything on the plane. As this thing's flying, every nut and bolt, rivet, seam is just constantly vibrating and rubbing on each other. So the more you balance the propeller, you're lessening that vibration, so you're lessening a lot of wear and tear. Especially the engine mounts, it's really important. So, you know, every piston airplane I've ever owned, I've had Leo come out and balance the props on it. It's always the first thing I do when I get a new airplane, because most owners don't do this, and I don't understand why you guys don't do it, but you should. It's very beneficial to the airplane, and it just makes the flying experience a lot better when you have a nice balanced propeller. So something to think about. So the plane is getting ready to go in for paint here soon, which is awesome. I gotta get Brett out here to polish that spinner. Shout out Brett Shiny Jets. But yeah, she's gonna go in for paint. Interior materials have already been ordered, so those are coming soon. But yeah, next on the list is paint. Then we'll get in here and start redoing the panel. You guys can see I already changed out the screen on that on the King unit. I still gotta change the screen on the KX155, and we gotta take this old POS GPS out of there. But we're getting there. I do love this plane. It's fun to fly.
All right, so we're ready to go. I want to talk about something really quick. Fun outside aviation here at Fullerton Airport.
It's actually the flight school where I learned to fly, 11, 12 years ago. My buddy Garrett owns it. It's a great flight school. They have an awesome fleet of 172s. I think he has an Aero or some other stuff also, but super cool people. It's one of his planes, so we're waiting for them to move it out of the way so I'm not blowing dust all over his freshly washed aircraft. But that being said, I get a lot of questions about where I started and where I learned to fly. So this is it, right here at Fullerton. Fun outside aviation, they're awesome. Garrett's a super awesome guy, really honest, great airplanes, maintains them well. And I blew through my private here, had a great instructor. And obviously that was a long time ago. My instructor has long moved on to flying jets also, but it's pretty cool. So just give you guys a little bit of backstory there. But as soon as they move this airplane right back here, we'll go ahead and fire this sucker up and I'll show you guys how we do the rest of the balancing process. All right guys, here we go. I'm not gonna take you guys on the startup because the start, I'm gonna need both hands, but so once we get up and going, I'll show you guys the process here, so give me 1 second. All right guys, the engine is running. Let it warm up and stabilize for a few seconds. Leo's turning the machine on. You ready? What did you say?
I'm good.
All right, let's go out and take a look at the little graph he just ran. I know this plane's a piece of shit, guys. I know. Don't worry. We're working on it. We're working on it.
I don't manipulate this machine.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
See, at idling, it go down. But, you know, if you're going to lean it out, it's going to go down. And then see the trace at 17. At 23, it peak over right here.
Right.
That's all, because the thing is over right there when you increase the power, you
right. Just yeah,
blah,
yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. But you see at 23.50.
There you go. That's how we do it. She's all set, balanced out. Time to pay the man. Life is good. All right, so that's it. We're all done here. Gonna go put the plane back in its parking spot now. And that's pretty much it. You know what? Let me not end this video real quick. Let me go show you guys this graph. We'll talk about it and then we'll close the video out. Okay, so as you guys can see here, the black are the initial runs. You see we're way up here in the gray, which is no good. 1700 RPM, we're still up here almost in the gray. And at 2000, we're about halfway up. The red is the final run here. You can see at 1700, we drop from up here to way the hell down here. 2000 RPM, we went from here to down here. And on the final run, we never hit 2350 on the beginning, but at the beginning, this little power change, this is the power change going from 2000 to 23. So that's that vibration there. But we actually brought it all the way down here to about 0.1 on the scale at 2300 RPM, which is roughly the cruise RPM on that plane. But yeah, that's what we're looking at. So this thing is doing amazing now. It's noticeably smoother while it's running. Life is so good. Leo is the goat. All right, so that's it. I'm gonna go ahead and end the video right here now. Any of you guys need to get your prop balance, Leo is the absolute goat. I've used him on over 7. This is my 8th airplane I've done with him now. A few $100, it's great peace of mind. And also knowing that you're not tearing up your engine mounts, you're putting undue stress on everything. If any guys need to get a prop balance in Southern California, Leo works all over SoCal. Just leave a message down below. I'll tell you how to get in contact with me and I'll put you in contact with Leo. So that being said, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching. Life is so good. Appreciate it. And we'll see you on the next one. Peace.